our profession is very different than other professions. Just remember that. We are distinguished. A patient who comes to us after getting the treatment, when he gets all right, he not only bends down, not only holds his hand, not only gives you the money, but he prostrates and says, "You are God." Why? Because the body is the most precious possession of a man. No sooner he finds some ailment stopping him to work further, he goes to the doctor and praises him with adjectives beyond the understanding. He wants the treatment done quickly, he wants to be out of the disease which is stopping him to continue his work. When a doctor goes to a community function, he is looked upon, at least we have enjoyed that conspicuousness by our presence, that he is a doctor. It doesn't happen with other professions like that. Or for that matter, if you have given back to the patient something, you have created a situation by virtue of the extra care, compassion. I don't have a word for it, but I can describe it to you, that when there is a one-eyed person, we are all telling that we are very careful. We are more careful. And when there is a two-eyed person, when we ask you, "Are you not careful?" He said, "I am equally careful." The difference between equally careful and more careful is abstract, not understandable, but it's something which we only have for the patient. And we must look into the best care we should give to the patient according to today's medicine. So we have the difficulty of meeting the compassion and competence. And there is a debate what to do. As you heard, the solo practice, Chitra told you, very sweet words, but didn't have the matter how to fight the situation. Individual, how he fares, I think the stories must be told about how they fared. We had the corporate practice is equally good as the group practice. We consider it as a part of it. The only difficulty is that there is a businessman at the top who doesn't understand the abstract between the one-eyed treatment and the two-eyed treatment. He's concerned with the evening collection. I have an example that a man, having been operated for cataract, was visiting a new city when he developed pain in the eye redness, and he went to the nearest eye surgeon, a corporate hospital person, and he said that you are developing infection, you must hurriedly get an injection into the eye, and that will cost you 3,000 rupees. And he said, "I can't afford, I'll go back to my surgeon." And they allowed him to go, which took him 6 hours to reach his surgeon. In the meantime, the treatable endophthalmitis had become an untreatable endophthalmitis. Just because they don't have at base level permission to give charity considerations, somehow the businessman at the top doesn't understand that clearly. Pritika has spoken from his her corporate center for sight, where we have a doctor, an eye surgeon at the top, who understands that. But not all corporates are behaving like that. So we have solo practice available between just heart, small town or big town, you can distinguish here also. The institutional attachments can be to the government, district level or metro level, corporates, which I just mentioned to you, and there are charitable trusts which are getting more and more interested in business. Part-time or already attachments sometimes people keep with their practice, and we have in our town a group practice of mobile type. They sit at home with their tobacco machine, or may not have that also. They get a telephone and they go to the same place where the eye surgeon is having the patient, they operate for him. No investment otherwise. There was a barter system earlier. I remember my father-in-law, a family doctor, would not charge for the consultation, but would give some medication in a bottle, labeled, dosing, cutting paper, colored substance, and at the end of it, he would charge some 50 paisas for that medication and nothing else. But it was a barter system. At the end of the his drop which is coming up, he would deliver a sack of wheat, some vegetables. That's how it was running. But the money came in between, it eroded with the values of the past, and we had to make exchanges. We are in a world very different today than what we started. As I started, it was a good torch and a new trial set and jack of telescope, near and distant vision charts. All that was sufficient to start practice. But today, with the introduction of the technology, the cost has become exorbitant. Lasers, ultrasound, others. Field analyzers, converted the chamber into a high-tech room. The investment of thousands have become lakhs and crores today. And he is under compulsion to redeem the investment because the banker is sitting there beside him asking for the next installment. And the patient who walks in becomes the victim of that banker. In a very sugar-coated way. And gradually, with the technology intruding into his practice, he becomes dehumanized, like his machine partners, who would do the job till the electricity is working and would do it very well once it is well paid. And we start flowing as market-driven society. Overall, the truth. Unfortunately, the practice of medicine today is as much a business as it is a science and art. The physician is known today as a healthcare provider. The patient is known as a customer or a client. The business management techniques are employed, including the advertising at the top of the voice today. In fact, we are not opposing advertising now. We are opening it to all of you to advertise so that it dilutes itself. Enforcement of the rules and regulations which we popularly call ethics have to be enforced by the physician himself. He has to heal himself. We have to maintain the nobility of and uniqueness of our profession. Sometimes it is odd time of the day that we work, but we work pleasantly. Whereas a corporate doctor would not stay longer than it's there. And the other time it is a non-affording patient who cannot pay anything, should not say no. If we put it philosophically, the whole world is one patient sitting across your table is also you in other reflections. The competence has to be also kept with the compassion. It's not that you will treat him with a lesser or a mediocre type. We have to have the present knowledge. Nelson Jackson has said very correctly, I do not believe you can do today's job with a yesterday's method and be in business tomorrow. So we have to maintain the competence by continuous medical education, attending the conferences, going to the courses. The doctor who stops learning goes backwards. Compassion and caring can set the doctor apart by the type of care provided. We must learn something from this picture which came from Munnabai MBBS. Look, it has been quoted in the British Medical Journal, the Jadu Ki Shakti. What matters is that which cures. 70% of the disease is psychological, which is associated with the organic 30%. The four C's of the doctor: competent, cost-effective, convenient, caring. And the fifth C was added by Dr. Talwar from Chandigarh: no to commercialization. For this, I do not totally agree. There is some limitation with it. As ophthalmologists, we are not adding years to the life.